Hello everyone. So as I mentioned in my last video, I am trying to refine my style a little bit more. So I've been trying to get into K makeup lately because I like the fact that it cares more about having like a moisture and healthy skin more than just like piling up tons of makeup on your face to make it look good. So in my previous video, I show you my Korean skincare routine that I've been using for a few years now. And on this video, I will be trying to recreate a Korean makeup on one half of my face, while my friend, who actually knows about makeup, will try to recreate it on the other side. The goal of this is for me to learn the do's and don'ts to adapting Korean makeup into your face, and basically any Asian makeup, because our physiognomy is not the same. So there are certain things that we have to take into account when doing so to make sure that the outcome is always going to be the best. So without further ado, let's start. So this is the makeup that we'll be recreating, and I've tried recreating Korean makeups in the past, but there's always something off. So hopefully today we can learn a little bit more about why that is off. Some things to take into account about my face are I have very big eyes. I already have a very natural eye color as well. My lips are a little darker on the outside and lighter on the inside. Another thing that I may be wrong with is I have very high cheekbones, and also my thick eyebrows, which are more arched. And I actually like that shape, so I don't really like Korean shape. I feel like this shape is a little better for me. In terms of skin, I haven't really found a base or a BB cream that actually is my tone. So I just cover some parts and leave the rest be. So what things do you think I should be taking into account? Like, I tried, but I probably didn't do it good, so... What things should I take into account, like, when trying to, like, without makeup on my face?
Okay, you have to keep in mind that you have different shape of your face. So you have to think about that when you try to recreate a makeup. And yeah, you have to follow the natural shape of your face, and we have to think about some specific things, like for example, you have to put for your lips something that help you to don't make these pads of color in here in the middle. And you have to put, you need to moisturize your lips and think about that you have different shape here. So if you have to add volume, you have to add a little bit of the dark color here in the bottom for your lips to create a more volume, and try to put highlight here because it's going to help with this illusion that your lips are a little bit bigger. And you have to consider the shape of your eyebrows because they are different. So the Korean girls have this shape straight. So you have a here different. So that's why it doesn't look the same, but it's okay, don't worry. And here in your eyes, you have different size. You have such a big eyes, you know? They are pretty beautiful, but they are different. They are bigger than the Korean girls. So you have to put this dark color in the end to try to make this shape like a V shape. You know, like this V shape. So maybe it could help to change a little bit the perception of your end. And here, when you are doing a Korean makeup, it's really important to think about the glitter because she loves use glitter. We don't have the same color, but we are working on it. So we are working when we have with the things that we have. And you have to add here in the middle of your eyes this glitter and the bottom over here because it's going to help you to get more attention here. This is your focus point here, so you can add glitter here and here, and going to help you. And well, I think that we have to use highlight here. You can add highlighter here, and it's going to help you with the shape of your face to look more slim. And I forget, but you can put here blush in the nose after using highlighter. But you can, it looks pretty when you add here because Korean makeup usually looks like something really cute. So when you add blush here, you have the illusion that you are snoozy and it looks so pretty. And I think that's it. Thank you so much.
I got anything else about my eye shape or blush? Like, I put blush like this, but I don't know if it's okay.
Well, it depends of what kind of shape do you like to focus on. I mean, if you want to have like a straight one, you cannot just blush here and here and that's it. But here we add blush here and it helps you to have this slim face. Yes, like a B face, you know. Mm-hmm. It helps with that. Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
This is the final look. Yeah, it obviously pops up more here. I don't know. What do you think? Thank you for watching. See you next time.